This is Matti Nykänen of Finland with his coach Matti Puuli. In the years leading to the Calgary Olympics, Matti Nykänen was considered an enigma. 4 years earlier at the Sarajevo Olympic Games, he won the gold medal in the 90-meter ski jump and the silver in the 70 meters. Many believed him to be the greatest ski jumper in the history of the sport, and it was almost unanimously predicted that he would win both the 70 and 90-meter events in Calgary. But following Sarajevo, Nykänen's personal conduct placed his career in jeopardy. He had to overcome bouts with alcohol, the police, the press, his teammates, and his lifelong coach.
He was 14 years old and made his first jumps on that big hill here. Since the first jumps, I said that, well, I will be your coach if you want. And so, because we've been a lot together, and that's one of the reasons why he's arguing a lot with me. It's like a son for his father.
Matti Nykänen's behavior was so offensive, he was twice thrown off the Finnish national team.
After Sarajevo, my life was different. I'm not happy with many things that happened, since they were printed in newspaper and spoken in television. However, when my son was born, it was the happiest of times and I felt a new purpose in life.
I'd say so that almost all Finnish people, they love Matti. But he got so much when he was so young that I think he didn't understand the whole life at that time, and I think that's one of the reasons. But now he's much older and wiser and becoming just the normal people.
It is 1:30 p.m. Sunday, February 14th, 1988. The 70-meter ski jump hill at the Calgary Olympic Winter Games. More than 50,000 spectators surround the landing area at the bottom of the hill. 58 men are entered. Each will take two jumps. Although the competition is decided by a combination of distance and style points, the jumpers with the longest distances are normally the medal winners. Very rarely do style points determine the winner, since it is generally assumed that to jump great distances, proper style is a prerequisite. Judges are spaced downhill at 1 meter intervals to record the distance of the jumps. The 70 meter championship is the first of three jumping events here at the Calgary Games. Before the 2 weeks are over, there will be two more events, the individual 90 meter championship and the team championship. There are some misconceptions shared by many about ski jumping. The term 70 or 90 meter hill is not the height of the tower. Rather, it is the distance from the takeoff point to the normal landing area, two-thirds down the hill. Also, there is an optical illusion for spectators. Once in flight, the jumpers rarely soar more than 10 feet off the ground. The competition gets underway. One by one, the jumpers go off. Finally, it is time for the 47th contestant, Matti Nykänen of Finland. Nykänen's speed down the in run is approximately 50 miles an hour, far slower than many of the other jumpers. But his liftoff and ability to soar cannot be matched. Nykänen leaps nearly 294 feet.
Matti Nykänen's jump, 89.5 meters to take the lead.
In the second and final round, Jiří Malac of Czechoslovakia gets off a tremendous leap to move into second place. At the bottom of the hill, he is greeted by his teammate Pavel Plotz, who earlier took the lead. Almost 294 feet. He knows the gold medal is his.
4 years earlier in Sarajevo, I had to settle for the silver medal in the 70 meters. Now I could look forward to winning the gold medal again in the 90 meters, as I had in Sarajevo.
Six days later, the 90-meter jump is scheduled, but the Calgary weather turns. High winds make the competition too dangerous for the jumpers. On Monday, February 22nd, the winds are still high. The event is postponed to the next day.
Every one of the athletes were a little bit nervous because nobody knew what's going to happen on the next day, and could it be possible even get through the whole competitions? So who could stand those conditions, he had a chance to win them.
It was very stressful for all of us, but I was prepared for this. The one who can keep his mental attitude in tune with his physical capabilities, of course, has the best chance.
Welcome to the 90-meter ski jumping competition.
Finally, on Tuesday, February 23rd, the winds are an acceptable 10 miles an hour. After two postponements, the competition will finally get underway. For Matti Nykänen, there is an opportunity to make Olympic history. 52 years earlier, in Garmisch-Partenkirchen, the legendary Birger Ruud of Norway won the 90-meter jump, repeating his performance of 4 years earlier at the 1932 Lake Placid Games. Now, here in Calgary, Matti Nykänen has a chance to enter the record books if he duplicates Birger Ruud's feat as the only man to win the event twice. Even more, he will become the first man in Olympic history to win three gold medals in ski jumping. Matti Nykänen is again superb. After the first round, his lead is so large that only a major catastrophe can deprive him of victory. Now, his second jump.
Our last jump of the afternoon, gold medalist.
When Matti Nykänen lands, he knows he has made Olympic history. That evening, the victory platform ceremony takes place before thousands of spectators in the Olympic Plaza.
Now that the individual competition was over, I look forward to joining my teammates for the team competition. It would be the first time at the Olympic Games that this event would take place.
There are 11 countries in the competition. Four men on each team. The winner is decided by the combined total of the best three jumpers in each of the two rounds. Matti Nykänen's teammates are outstanding. But it is just a prelude to the appearance of the Olympic champion. And Matti Nykänen has won his third gold medal here in Calgary. For Matti Nykänen, his four gold and one silver medal place him in an exalted position in the history of Finland at the Olympic Games. Shortly after the Games, Matti Nykänen returned to his home in Jyväskylä, about 275 kilometers north of Helsinki. There, thousands greeted him on a cold winter night. To the Finns, Matti Nykänen epitomizes the spirit and tradition of their homeland, bringing back memories of their great Olympians of the past, a heritage that is steeped in an almost mystical philosophy, centuries old. The love of the outdoors, the sun, the woods. The Finnish word, sisu, unyielding courage, stamina, fortitude. With his victories, Matti Nykänen has made Olympic history and joins his legendary countrymen of the past, who will be known for all time as the Flying Finns.
Good luck to you.
A te, 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 a